Okay, we will start to discuss about join first, because before we have not to discuss about this content, about this lesson, join. In Indonesia, in Bahasa Indonesia, we call join as sendi. Okay, join is the part that we connecting one bone and the other bones, okay? So join is the connecting part between two or more bones. We know about that there is three parts of join, okay? The first thing is synaptic join from the text Mr. Nengah has been right in slide. Synaptic is immovable joint. For example, who remember in which part in our body we have synaptic joint? Which part in our body we have synaptic joint? In which part in our body we have synaptic joint? Who can remember? In which part? Synaptic joint is immovable joint. It's immovable joints. Unmoved or static joint. In which part in our body? In our body we have immovable joint. In which part? Who remember? Ibe maybe? Ibe, do you remember?
Oh, gitu bisa.
In which part in our body we have synaptic joint or immovable joint? Do you know immovable mean? Immovable.
Yeah. Tidak bisa bergerak.
Immovable, tidak bisa bergerak. Or Mr. Nga say before static joint. In which part in our body we have immovable joint? In our head.
Bone
in our head. We
in our head.
In
our head.
Okay. Head. In full. Okay. Head. Mostly. Head. Mostly joined in our head bones or in our skull is synaptic joint or immovable joint. Okay. Second one we have amphiatrosis or slightly movable. And then we have diatrosis. Diatrosis is joint that can freely movable. Okay? That can freely movable. Jadi yang bisa bergerak secara bebas. We know that about six or five. We have six, okay? Ball and socket, hinge, condyloid, pivot and gliding, and saddle, okay? So that is the parts of joint, yeah? Ball and socket is same with ball and socket? It's same with ball and socket? Same with ball and socket? Same with peluru. And you can find the other main, the other name of hinge, condyloid, pivot, and gliding set. And saddle, okay? Okay, we focus on the new material, okay? In the new lesson, in the new content. So, what pictures you can see in the slide, in your screen?
Plan.
Okay, thank you.
The plan.
Sure? Are you sure? Yes.
Three.
Tree. Okay. Plant, tree. What else?
It's the same thing.
Why show you the pictures of a tree in your slide? Because today we will discuss about plant movement, okay? Plant movement. The plant's movement different with human and animal's movement. If animals can be moved in every time they need, but plan need more time to moving. This lesson not mean plants move by a wind, by a water, no. But in this lesson, we will discuss why plants move by itself. Okay. Jadi bergerak yang dimaksud di sini bukan bergeraknya seperti binatang, seperti manusia, tetapi kalau binatang manusia bisa bergerak kapan saja mereka mau ya. Seperti misalkan menggerakkan tangan seperti ini. For example, Mr. Nengah Mr. Nengah fingers like this. Okay. But a plant cannot doing like that. So it can move, but in different way, in different moving method. So in the great part, we can divide into three great parts of plant movement. The first thing is endonorm. Okay, endonorm. Second one is hygroscopic. The third one is aisonom. Okay, we have three great how a plant move. How a plant can be moved. Jadi kita punya tiga cara sebuah tumbuhan kita bisa katakan bergerak ya. First thing, endonorm. Okay, endonorm. 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 Who knows endonorm? Endonorm. Endonorm move is. Endonorm move is. Endonorm. Who knows? Please open your CBMA first and download.
Endonorm motion is the motion caused by stimuli.
Dasian.
Endonorm motion is the motion caused by stimuli from within.
Within. Stimuli from?
Within. Apa baca itu?
Within, okay. Endonorm, it's mean a movement by a plant, doing by plant. This caused by within itself. So, in Indonesia, misalnya jelaskan ya. In Indonesia, misalnya explain. Gerak endonorm ini adalah gerakan dari tumbuhan yang penyebabnya tidak lain, tidak bukan. Itu berasal dari dalam tubuhnya sendiri, ya. Dari tubuhnya sendiri. For example, in Mr. Nengah text in part 3, Mr. Nengah read movement of chloroplast, for example. Okay, so it means there's no cause by outer side. For example, there's no cause from sunlight, there's no impact from chemical substance outside of the plant from water just because of itself internal of the plant. Jadi murni penyebabnya itu disebabkan dari dalam tumbuhannya ya. That's about the endonorm. Second one we have hygroscopic. Hygroscopic
motion is the motion caused by the effect of change in water chain.
Okay.
Content.
Change caused by the effect of change in water content. What does that mean?
Disebabkan karena ada perubahan dalam airnya.
Okay, because of the change of content. Maybe it can be more or less. Became more water or less water, that is can make a plant that can make plant moving, okay, moving. Jadi ketika misalkan kandungan airnya water containing in a plant became greater, became more or less, jadi itu bisa juga membuat tanaman itu menjadi bergerak ya. Itu hygroscopic. High grow, it's mean water. So, this from inner, distilled from inner side, okay. But especially in this case, in hygroscopic, that cause the change of water content. Okay. Jadi hampir sama kayak yang endonom ya. Cuma di hygroscopic ini, dia lebih fokus kepada penyebabnya itu ada air yang berasal dari dalam dirinya sendiri. Oke. Okay. And the third, the last.
Me.
Endonom.
Me.
Be. Okay, Sima udah.
Iya, aku belum, Cu.
Oh iya, kamu belum ya? Ada sekian ya?
Ethionom motion is plants that include ethionom. There are three kinds of motion. That is trapism.
Ethionom
motion.
Oke. Itu gininya kan, itu apa namanya? Terjemah. Itu masih belum ada pengertiannya ya.
Oh, iya,
ethionom. Ethionom is endonom caused by within the plant, and then ethionom is caused by the outer side. Wind. Okay, the outer side of a plant. Okay.
The wind.
Endonom come from the plant. Ethionom is come from outer the side of the plant. There's the difference.
What?
Okay. Huh? Ethionom is a moving trigger from outer side of plant. Outer side of plant. Jadi dari rangsangan dari luar, trigger dari luar. Kalau misalkan endonom, itu penyebabnya dari dalam tanamannya sendiri. Bisa dibedakan? Ya. Okay. In the grid part, as we can divide ethionom movement into three. The first thing is taxis, nasty, and tropism. Okay. Taxis, nasty, and tropism. You can correct the nasty, the in English nasty is nasty using C, nasty. N-I-S-T-I-C. And then tropism without E. T-R-O-P-I-S-M. Just like that. Without E. Okay? Nasty is nasty in English. Nasty is nasty in English. And tropism in English is tropism without E. Okay? Okay, can you understand? You can repair in your like in our text in part 3. In part 3. Okay. So what's the difference between taxis, tropism, and nasty? What's the difference? Okay. Let's we start from tropism first. Okay. Tropism. Okay, tropism. Who knows what is tropism move? Who knows?
Me.
Siapa? And then the other.
Me.
Yeah.
I'm tropism.
Mister, saya belum, Mister.
Saya juga belum. Orang saya salah tadi.
Sima. Sima.
Tropism is the movement.
Okay.
Wait. Tropism is the movement of part of plant that is affected by the stimuli of from the outside.
Stimuli from outside.
Outside.
Okay. Nasty is stimuli by outside too. success is based on the outside too. Why special about what the special thing, special characteristic of tropism? Special characteristic of tropism. Who knows? You can compare in your science in IPA books in IPA. See? Jadi kalian bisa mencarinya juga di IPA ya. Can you make difference, okay, between tropism and toxic? Tropism and nasty. Sorry. Okay, misalnya I will explain in English and Indonesia, okay? Because in this definition, okay, you must understand what the difference. Tropism is the move of plant caused by outer side of plant. Jadi gerakan tanaman yang disebabkan oleh rasa dari luar, outer side trigger that can depend on search on trigger direction. Jadi sangat bergantung pada arah dari rangsangannya. Depend on the direction of trigger. Okay, misalnya trigger itu artinya rangsangan ya, pemicu. Okay, for example, misalnya give an example. If you sometimes you want to play a plant, okay? If sometimes you want to place a plant in a dark room, okay? Jadi ya, suatu hari misalkan kalian mau meletakkan sebuah tanaman dalam sebuah ruangan yang gelap. In every day there will be grow to find a sunlight, okay? To find a sunlight. So it is mean a plant growth or a plant movement is based on sunlight, and the plant growth will follow from where the sunlight comes. Ya, jadi dalam kondisi seperti itu, dalam kondisi tanaman pada keadaan gelap, dia akan mengikuti yang namanya sinar mataharinya itu. Misalkan melalui jendela tuh, sinar mataharinya dari jendela, maka pertumbuhannya akan datang arahnya ke jendela. That is the example of tropism movement. So it's based on source or trigger direction. Jadi sangat bergantung dari mana datangnya sumbernya itu, ya. That is tropism. But in nastic, okay, in nastic, nastic is not depending on the search trigger. Can you understand? Jadi dia nggak peduli arahnya dari mana. Not depending on search or trigger direction. Tidak peduli dari mana arah datangnya rangsangan itu ya. Okay, there is the difference between tropism and nastic. Okay, let's we talk in every part of Asianom movement, okay? Okay, setengah not translate yet. In taxis, we have phototaxis, chemotaxis. In nastic, we have seismonastic, nictinastic, photonastic. Okay, and thermonastic. Setengah in tropism, we have phototropism, geotropism, hydrotropism, sigmotropism, chemotropism. Okay. Setengah said before the example of tropism movement. Okay, which one from this this part of tropism movement that Mr. explained before? Jadi yang mana yang Mr. Nengah jelaskan sebelumnya? Phototropism, geotropism, hydrotropism, sigmotropism, or chemotropism? Okay, with help of phototropism, okay, because of this will follow the sunlight, okay, the plant will follow the sunlight direction, okay, there's the phototropism. Geotropism, who knows the geotropism? Geo. Okay, geo, it's mean, Mr. Nengah, have a picture of
Earth.
Pictures of Earth. Okay, so what does that mean, geotropism?
It's depending by the
Earth. Affected by gravity,
depending
oh, yeah.
by?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Affected by gravity.
By the gravity.
Okay, Amanda.
Okay, good. Okay, the geotropism is tropism movement that caused by the center of Earth. Okay, it's caused by center of Earth about the caused by gravity. Okay, who can tell me an example of geotropism? Who can?
Earthquake.
Earthquake. No,
yeah.
we discuss about a plane movement. We discuss about plane movement.
Me.
Ibe, isa na nga one. The other, isa na nga one. Oh.
Yeah.
No,
what?
Ibe, no Manda.
No, please
what?
Help me.
Cara apa misal pertanyaannya?
Who can give isa na nga example of geotropism movement?
Me, I can.
Dandy, can you help Mr. Nanga to find the answer? Dandy, geotropism.
Mr., why cannot we answer this question, Mr.?
No.
Because you have answered before. So
what?
Let's give a chance for another student.
They won't answer.
I only answer once.
Okay, Dandy, can you?
No.
Can you?
No.
No. We sell?
No, I don't.
We sell? Can you give Mr.
No,
Nanga example of geotropism?
Me, I can. Help me, please.
Bintang.
Harus dijawab ini.
Nah.
Help me.
You don't need to.
We sell? Can you find? We sell? Example of geotropism.
Aduh. Harus saya?
Yeah, your chance.
Your chance to answer this question. Dude, come on.
Let's go, bro, let's go.
Come on. Okay, George, can you?
Oh.
Let's we jump to George. George, can you? George?
No.
Example of geotropism. Okay.
No.
Nathan?
Yeah.
Nathan? Hello.
Okay.
Hello.
Example of geotropism.
Gravity.
What?
Plant movement. We discuss about plants movement.
Oh, okay.
Okay, who can? Who can?
Plants grow.
Grow?
Bentar. Towards the gravitational force.
What? Can hear your voice?
The example.
Plants grow towards the gravitational force.
Okay. Plants. Example. Is it not one air example?
Me.
Aksa, example definition.
Okay, Mr. Nanga, one, two.
Aku Manda?
Apa?
Wait.
Apa sih? Nih. Mr. Saya mau jawab.
Arjun? Can you? Arjun, can you?
No.
Can you not? No. Okay.
Me. Saya deh.
Ya, Ibe.
Ya.
Wis, mantap. The example of geotropism is the roots grow downward into the ground.
Okay.
Yeah, saya kan bilang
while the growth of the stem that is always pointing up.
Okay, thank you Nathan. I think Mr. Nanga don't hear you.
No, he didn't even say anything.
Okay, I'm sorry. Thank you, Nathan. Thank you, Nathan, for answering.
Nathan didn't even say anything, Mr.
Okay, skip. He's Aneta.
I apologize to
Aneta.
Your answer. So, the example of gas lobster is the example of geotropism is
me.
Santai bang.
So, Mr. Nga, give Mr. Nga time to explain. The example of geotropism is the root growth. Okay, root growth. Mostly a plant has a root. Okay, mostly a plant has a root, and this root will grow into downward into the center of earth man. Jadi sebagian besar ya akar-akar tumbuhan itu arahnya ke bawah ya. So that's about the geotropism. The second the third is hydrotropism. Hydro, Mr. Nga has pictures of water. So what is hydrotropism mean?
Rain.
Me.
Yang belum dong, yang belum.
Me.
Hydrotropism.
Okay.
Bastian, can you help Mr. Nga?
Me.
Bastian.
Yeah, Mister.
Okay, can you help Mr. Nga? Why hydrotropism mean?
Sam, stop doing that.
Me.
Can you help Mr. Nga, Bastian?
Diam. Root tip grows in the soil, which always lead to place and contains water.
Okay.
What?
The root in the soil always will grow into the place that has some water. So. Okay. Not good. That's good.
Yeah.
So it's that name or every plant, mostly plants in our earth, especially for the root type, in the root part, will be growth, and they will grow
if we
the place that has enough, that has water enough. Okay. Pasti tumbuhan yang ada di bumi ini ya, sebagian besar, dia akan mempunyai akar yang dimana akarnya itu akan bergerak ya ke tempat yang punya cukup air. Seperti itu. Akan bergerak ke tempat yang punya cukup air. That's why to make a plant growth better, okay, have a better growth, we need to watering a plant every day. Jadi itu alasannya kenapa kalian harus menyiram tanaman ya, karena ketika misalkan kalian tidak siram, dia akan energinya itu pertumbuhannya akan habis untuk nyari air itu. Jadi ketika misalkan sudah dekat, penyerapan airnya akan terjadi secara lebih baik, seperti itu ya. Itu. There's hydrotropism. Stigmotropism. Stigmo. Misalnya have a hand picture in stigmotropism.
Me, please help me.
Lia.
Me.
What?
Me. Yeah.
Me.
Please give chance for Lia. Mr. Nga want.
Okay.
Lia. Stigmotropism. Stigmo, Mr. Nga, give you a clue. Stigmo is touch, about touch. Touch, sentuhan ya. What does that mean? What is stigmotropism mean? Okay, Lia, can you, yes or no? Bisa? Stigmotropism. No? Okay, misalnya one orbit. Stigmotropism. You can read in the text that misalnya upload in CBMA in the part 3. Sigmotropism. What is sigmotropism? Sigmotropism. Okay, let's we jump, let's we change them into okay. Zaka, can you hear Mr. Nanga? Zaka? Zaka?
Yes.
Okay, Zaka, good. Okay, Zaka, please, what is sigmotropism? Sigmotropism. You know, Zaka, sigmotropism? Okay, jump, Arjun. Zaka, wait. Zaka, can you help Mr. Nengah? Sigmotropism, Zaka?
I don't know.
I don't. Okay, Arjun. Please, Arjun. Can you? Sigmotropism? Hair.
Sigmotropism is the directional response of a plant organ to touch of physical contact with a solid object.
Okay. The sigmotropism is based on the movement. Mr. Nanga, repeat. The movement that caused by touching side physical or physical context of plant organ is called we call it by sigmotropism. Jadi sigmotropisme ini adalah gerak tumbuhan yang disebabkan oleh sentuhan, ya, ada kontak fisik antara tumbuhan dengan suatu tumbuhan dengan suatu benda. Misalkan saja kalian misalkan menanam tanaman yang merambat, apa ya, tanaman yang merambat, contohnya watermelon, okay? Watermelon, ya, semangka, ya. For example, you plant a watermelon, so the watermelon tree will be growth, okay, will be growth, ya, akan tumbuh, akan melilit, ya kan, akan melilit sebuah benda biasanya, kan. Nah, untuk itu kalian, agar lilitannya itu tidak mengganggu, misalkan kalian taruh sebuah tiang, ya, dekat pohon tanaman semangka itu, you place a pole in the near of the watermelon tree, so the watermelon tree will grow to follow the pole. Jadi pasti nanti pohon semangka itu akan tumbuh, akan mengikuti dari tiang itu. Jadi dia akan melilit tiangnya, ya kan? Jadi itu biasanya sigmotropisme ini biasa terjadi pada tanaman-tanaman yang wujudnya melilit, ya. Okay. Sigmotropism is mostly happen on, melilit itu bahasa Inggrisnya apa, ya? Melilit itu bahasa Inggrisnya apa, ya? What is the in English?
Apaan, Mister?
Melilit. Wrap. Wrap. Tangle. Wrap. Around. Okay? So, Mr. Nengah, repeat in English. Sigmotropism always or mostly happen on wrapping plants. For example, a cucumber. For example, a grapes. For example, a watermelon. For example, and the others. Oke, okay. Jadi sigmotropisme ini biasanya terjadi pada tanaman-tanaman yang melilit, ya, tanaman-tanaman. Jadi dia akan mengikuti biasanya apa yang menjadi yang mau bagian benda yang mau dia lilit, ya. That is sigmotropism. And then the last in tropism part is chemotropism. Chemotropism. Bisa dengar, has a pictures of. Who knows these pictures mean? These pictures mean?
Chemical.
chemical. Okay, this is Erlenmeyer lamp. Okay, Erlenmeyer tube, Erlenmeyer glass, Erlenmeyer cup. Okay, this mean in chemotropism, the plant growth is following is follow a chemical substance. Okay, the following chemical substance. For example, if we have a plant, as a plant, in near of this plant, we have urea. You know urea? We have fertilizer. Okay, fertilizer. Okay, fertilizer. Misalkan ada tanaman di sekitar itu ada pupuk. Jadi biasanya mostly the plant will grow to reach this fertilizer. Ya. Jadi biasanya tanaman ini akan mendekat menuju ke pupuknya ini, entah itu akarnya atau entah itu apanya. Tapi biasanya sih mostly is the root side, the root part. Jadi dia akan menuju ke akarnya itu, ya. Okay, that is about the tropism. So, misalnya repeat again, tropism is based on from where the triggers come, ya. Jadi sangat bergantung tropisme ini dari mana rangsangan itu atau trigger itu datang, ya. Kalau misalkan kayak tadi cahaya matahari, for example, if the sunlight come from east, so plant movement will come to east. Okay. For example, we have water in the west side. Airnya ada di barat. So the plant root will grow to the west side and the others. Okay? Yeah, Mr. Ngal repeat again. Tropism is based on from where the trigger comes. From where the triggers come. Okay. And then the nastic. Nastic. Okay. Nastic. So what is nastic? Who knows nastic movement is? Nastic movement is? Nastic movement is? Nastic movement is?
The motion of plant in response to stimuli that come from outside.
In easiest language, in the easiest. Itu yang lebih mudahnya? Easier language, please? Bahasa yang lebih mudah? Okay, this is different from tropism, okay? The trigger, the search of trigger come from other side, but this movement in the nastic not depending on from where the trigger comes. Jadi tidak berpengaruh dari mana datangnya rangsangannya, ya. Not depend on trigger come. Not depend on from where trigger comes. Tidak dipengaruhi oleh dari mana rangsangan itu datang, ya. For example, Mr. Nengah,
Mimosa.
The easiest example. Seismonastic. Seismic artinya? Seismic gelombang. Artinya? Gelombang? No. Seismic means?
Menutup.
Ini namanya apa? Kayak itu namanya apa?
Getaran. Okay.
Apa itu?
Kayak gini namanya apa? Kayak gini namanya apa?
Oh.
Nah. Getaran in English? Getaran?
Vibrate.
Getaran. Please help me sekarang. Getaran is vibration. Okay, vibration. Vibration. Caused by vibration, we name seismonastic. Okay. Example. Putri Malu dalam bahasa Inggris apa ya?
Mimosa.
Princess Princess Sai? No, no, I think not Princess Sai. Putri Malu,
Mimosa.
No.
Mimosa.
Princess.
Mimosa. Okay. Yeah. If we touch Putri Malu, okay? Putri Malu, Mimosa. We have touched. Okay, you have touched. We have touched Mimosa.
Yeah.
Mimosa. It will be close, okay? Okay, it will be close. Can you, have you ever seen Mimosa plants before? Pernah nggak kalian lihat Putri Malu sebelumnya? Pernah nggak?
Pernah.
Pernah. Di mana biasanya? Where usually we can find Mimosa?
Di semak-semak.
Semak-semak?
Di pinggir jalan.
Di rumput-rumput gitu, Sir.
The seismonastic example this is in this fact is this woman shame. Woman shame. Mimopudica. Okay? Mimopudica. This is monastic. Nictinastic. Who knows? Nictinastic. Nictinastic.
Nictinastic is sleeping motion of the plants because of the dark stimuli.
Okay. Based on dark night or day. Okay. If the night comes, the plants will be sleep, and if the day comes, there's be open. Okay. And then we have photonastic and thermonastic, okay? And then the last is taxis. Taxis, who knows? Taxis motion is? Taxis motion is? Taxis.
Photonastic.
Yes. Taxis, taxis.
That causes by photosynthesis.
Taxis, taxis. We move what? To... From nastic to taxis, taxis.
Oh. Oh, body movement of plant due to presence of external stimuli.
Bener nggak bisa?
Wait.
Di materinya ada.
Ya. Taxis is. Kalau tadi gini ya, kalau tadi kan tropisme, if the tropism is the part of body will be moved. Nastic is same. A part of body, not all of plant body will be moved. But in taxis, the moving will be doing by all of this part of body. Jadi dilakukan oleh semua, hampir bagian semua bagian tubuh dari bagian dari tanamannya, itu kalau taxis. Tapi kalau nasib dan tropisme itu hanya dilakukan oleh beberapa bagian saja. Misalkan daun-daunnya saja atau akar-akarnya saja. Oke, okay. You can read the phototaxis and chemotaxis. Oke, okay. Okay. There's about the moving of plant. So, today to assess you, Mr. Nenga will give you evaluation policy berapa jadinya?
Dua.
Okay, policy dua. Okay. Can you show? Can you see policy dua? Can you see? In CBMA? Evaluasi dua. Okay. You can answer this test, okay? You can answer this test by using English.